data are all of the facts and figures that we collect in our research. Now, typically, we code our data as numbers, although sometimes we use full words or maybe just letters. When we organize our data into meaningful groupings, we call them variables. If we use numbers in our variables, it is vital that we know what job each number is performing. Does that number 2 mean that this individual is in the second group, or that she came in second place, or that he scored 2 points, or that that movie is rated 2 out of 5 stars? When numbers stand in for names, such as number 2 being the number on your football jersey, or your student ID number, or indicating your belonging to the control group, which we coded as number 2, then that number is nominal. Naming variables are called nominal data, and they simply define differences between groups. If, however, the number tells us when an event occurred, such as you came in second place, or this is your second visit, or your TikTok dance is number 2 on the top 10, that number is ordinal. Ordinal data are numbers that convey an order or a rank. Like nominal variables, ordinal variables indicate a difference between groups, but they also show a direction of difference. You can't compare nominal scores, except to know that the red team is different than the blue team. But with ordinal scores, you can compare within the rankings. The valedictorian is always first place in the graduating class. The winner of the race is always the fastest runner in that race. But you cannot compare between rankings. You cannot tell if the winner of this year's race is faster than last year's winner, or if this year's valedictorian is smarter than last year's. Both nominal and ordinal data are categorical data. They both define categories or groups. Now, if the categorical variables have an underlying order, then they are ordinal. If the categories are unordered, then they are nominal. Both nominal and ordinal data can be numeric, coded only as numbers. Some nominal data may be coded as letters or words, such as experimental and control for the research groups, or M and F for male and female. When nominal data are coded as words or letters, they are called string variables in SPSS. String variables can contain a combination of letters, numbers, or even symbols. Now, there are 2 more levels of measurement that we will discuss in the next video, and they are scale level variables, interval and ratio data, also called continuous data or quantitative variables. Scale data tell us an amount. They tell us how much of a difference exists. Let's look at our data. Which of our variables are categorical? We have 4 categorical variables in this data set. 3 are nominal, and 1 is ordinal. Remember that the dog ID number is for identification, not for analysis. Now, why is breed nominal, but size ordinal? The 3 breeds are different, but they do not have an underlying order. Even though they are assigned as values of 1, 2, or 3, you cannot multiply Chihuahua by Fuzzy Dog. The numbers simply tell us which category the dog belongs to. Small, medium, and large, on the other hand, are different, but they also have that underlying order that tells us their relative size. Large dogs are bigger than small dogs, even if we don't know by how much. Let's review what you have learned. You now understand that both nominal and ordinal data are categorical. Ordinal data have ordered categories, but nominal data do not. You know how to create frequency tables for individual categorical variables and which measures of central tendency and dispersion to choose.